We'd like to say our gratitude to God who has given us guidance, happiness, healthy, and mercy so we could attend and participate in this very special event today. We would like to also would like to welcome Ali Institute of Design and Business Rector, Ms. Nika Desturiani, and also our first Vice Rector, Mr. Iputu Darmawan, and also all of the Head of Study Program who already attend this seminar today, and our respected lecturer of Bali Institute of Design and Business, and also all of our beloved students. Okay, before we start our journey today with Mr. Rob, would like to invite all of the audience, all of you guys, to pray together before we start this really special event today. So, let's close our eyes and start our prayer. Okay, thank you. Okay, but don't forget to mention, we also accompanied by a famous moderator today. To lead our seminar today, please welcome Mr. Andreas James Darmawan. Big applause for Mr. James. And Mr. James is one of the best lecturers in Bali Institute Design and Business, majoring in visual design and communication study program. Yeah, and he also experienced as a speaker with a really many seminar, right, Mr. James? Yeah, absolutely right. Okay, and he also have a lot of experience, both theoretical and also practical. So, on this grateful morning, we have several agendas as follows. The first one, welcoming and greeting from Mr. Iputu Darmawan as our Vice Rector, first Vice Rector, and also our main event, the presentation from Mr. Rob as our speaker today, and also Q&A from the audience. And we will also have a photo session, Mr. Rob, with the moderator, with Vice Rector, and also with all of the audience. Okay, so, well, everyone, guys, let's begin this event by following our very first agenda. We'd like to invite Mr. Iputu Darmawan to welcome and greet all of our audience, both in offline and also online, because we do it in online also, through the Zoom and also YouTube. Okay, so Mr. Iputu, the time and place is yours. Thank you.
Okay, good morning, everybody.
Amen.
The Honorable Rector IDB Bali, Ms. Nika Desturiani. The Honorable Second Prize Rector IDB Bali, Ms. Komang Prasiani. The Honorable Mr. Rob Panlum, as the guest speaker for our two-day seminar, who have taken the time to come to Indonesia, especially to Bali, for sharing entrepreneurship knowledge with our younger students. My Honorable Mr. Gede Yuda Anugrah Pratama, Mr. James Darmawan, and Mr. Pedi Indrawan, as our moderator during this seminar. My Honorable Mr. Mrs. Head of Division of IDB Bali and MMC, who attend this event via Zoom online. My beloved, all IDB Bali and MC students who have volunteered to attend this event, through offline, Zoom, or YouTube. Not to forget, my admirable pillar committee members who prepare this event so that be held well and smooth. Please accept my regards. Om Swastiastu. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Namo Buddhaya. Well greeting for all of us. It is a pleasure for us, the EDB Bali Councilor team, for holding the Entrepreneurship Series seminar with three of this seminar. With three of this tema, Millennial Planner for today, which is for our first day, Entering UX Normal in Business Creative for our second day, and Utilization of Information Technology as a Business Solution for our last day. Today's seminar was held and several discussion with Mr. Pandun himself as entrepreneur, as well as an inspirational person who already has several forms of business in several countries. Hopefully with this seminar, your student can gain knowledge and experience from our speaker so that we all can trigger younger siblings to become young entrepreneurs. Also, we can learn how to build a business in several different countries through our guest speaker network experience. So on this occasion, I ask from our attendee to give applause for our special guest speaker and moderators. And also applause for all of you who gain knowledge and experience by attending this seminar. Please. Thank you. That's all. At the same time, I open our entrepreneurship seminar series with guest lecturer, Mr. Rob Pandun. Allow me to close with Paramasanti. Om Santi, 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 Om. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. We're greeting for all of us. Thank you.
Not yet, Mr. Rob. A little bit patient, please. Just like I said, you're really energetic. Okay. Okay. Thank you, Mr. Putu Darmawan, as welcome and greet our audience today. And so, without further ado, I'd like to give and trust the running of this event to our moderator, Pak James.
Thank you, Pak. Selamat pagi, adik-adik sekalian. Halo, ya. Thank you ya sudah datang ke sini pagi-pagi, ya. Dan kami sangat appreciate banget kalian bisa hadir di sini karena kita mau belajar dari expertnya langsung, Mr. Rob Pandun. Guten Morgen, Rob. Welcome up Bali. Is that correct? Okay, correct. I just Google it. So, okay, for today's event, we are trying to introduce Mr. Rob first. Then all of you can know how who he is actually. And Rob Pandun is a dynamic, energetic, and very famous business coach in terms of serial entrepreneur. Nowadays, he coaches people in ambition, mindset, startup, business, and how to find the happiest job position that it fits best. He also mentors various incubator and growth programs. His mission is to influence as much as people as possible in find clarity, creating self-confidence, and setting goal in entrepreneurship and business. He also an author of his published book, The Journey of Young Entrepreneurship. This book is available in three languages, such as Dutch, English, and Indonesian. So we can learn about it, yeah, together. So after that, he's starting his own business on age 27. Rob was a founder and a owner of the Holland Events until April 2020. When he declares bankruptcy due to the COVID pandemic crisis, the company was the market leader in the province of North Holland, above Amsterdam. In the tour operator and even branch management. Starting at young age, Rob was connected in society many ways. He volunteered for Roundtable International and organized many charity events. on a voluntary base, which is from the UNESCO, yeah? The UNESCO, guys, wow. Okay, and in his late 20s, he connect himself with local politics. He also started his own independent business platform called smartkickstart.nl. So you can go to their website, guys, smartkickstart.nl. This website is to bring entrepreneurs together by organizing inspiring workshops. Now he also coach people on a proactive and energetic attitude with the goal to let them be successful and happy entrepreneurs and employees. Especially in hospitality, customer journey strategies, personal development and young entrepreneurship are themes that he is passionate with. As a guest lecturer, public speaker, writer, and coach, he extremely specialized in startups entrepreneurship, incubator program coaching, and creating business from the scratch. So please, we would like to welcome again Mr. Rob van Loon from Netherlands. Give an applause to him. Thank you, Mr. Rob. The place is yours. Knock yourself out.
Passionate with. As a guest lecturer, public speaker, writer, and coach, he extremely specialized in startups, entrepreneurship, incubator.
Good morning again. It's great to be here, and I'm really honored and privileged to be in Bali. I'm here together with my wife and my boy, 4 years old, and I'm combining working together with quality time. In the next 50 minutes, I'm going to share a lot of information. I'm going to try to speak not that quick and fast in English, because it is my goal that every one of you can follow me until the end. We are going to do a Q&A at the end. So if you have any question that cannot wait, please raise your hand. If you have a question that can wait, please hold it, and then we discuss it. There has been enough information about me, and from now on, I wanna talk about you and share my experience as an international business coach. I need to put it on, of course. I'm gonna ask you, sorry. Okay, thanks a lot. So what I want to share with you in the next time is all about mindset. Because I want to learn you that there are so many opportunities to start up your own business. But we actually don't realize it. And I want to learn you how to find your opportunities in just starting up a business. Because it's really, really a chance to build up your own financial free life. So, I'm going to be here today and tomorrow as well. And actually the fact that you are here, that is the first step that you took to really build up your own future. You don't need to be here, but you made the choice. And to be honest, you are responsible for your own success and for your own failure. That's my opinion. But what we do in general as a human, when we have success, we all say, hey, that's because of me. And when we have a failure, we are blaming other people or our environment. But honestly, you are responsible for your own success, but also for your own failure. So thank you very much for being here. I have been in Bali several times. I've been doing these seminars not only on Bali, but also on Java and Lombok. And I am privileged that I have the mission to empower students in your generation to step up and to create goals. Because honestly, if you don't create any goal in your life, there is not going to be any process. If there is no goal, there is no plan. And what I wish for you is that you don't have a life that is just going on day by day by day without any improvement, without any growth. So here's a picture of my family and my baby boy. He's 4 years old now. And I am so blessed that I can show him the world and combine my mission with my family life. So, as the introduction already said, I've been traveling to over 50 countries already in my life. I have seen many countries where there is a lot of poverty, where there are a lot of challenges, and it makes me blessed. And that is also the reason why 9 years ago I decided to coach young adults and students. Because in my opinion, everything starts on the young age, and that is your age. You are blessed that you are an average of 20, sometimes even more years younger than I am. I'm 42, and I'm jealous on you. And what I want is that everything I learned, I want to share a bit with you, so you have a positive advantage, and you can do things even better than I did them. That's your task. I actually have a question for you as well, and the question is, yeah, these are my books. The question is, there has been a research worldwide, and the research was about what we, as a human being, what do we find difficult to say to another person? So when you're walking on the street or at home with your family, what do we find difficult to say to another person? Any idea? Raise hands. What do we find difficult to talk about? What do we find difficult to say to someone else? Any ideas? Come up.
Apa yang bikin susah kalau kita ketemu orang tuh start ngomong itu apa yang bikin susah? Pakai bahasa Indonesia juga boleh. Perhaps siapa yang mau jawab?
Here.
Okay, sometimes we are going to a little bit, not really a little bit, but a lot of difficult to take the lesson on. Okay, so not sometimes, but mostly we are difficult to talk to the other because we put a high expectation about what they feel about what we talk, what are we going to say, and yeah, that make us lack of confidence, yeah, to have a conversation with the other.
Thank you very much. Who has another idea? Which subject, which theme do we find difficult to say to another person? Raise hands. Anyone? I'm going to give you the top three. And it is my mission to change the worldwide top three in what we find difficult. On three, I am sorry. Do we recognize this? Yeah. I'm sorry. It was my fault. I should have done better. On two, and I'm interested if you have the same in your life. On two, we find it difficult to say, I love you. We realize that? And what is on number one? And that is why I am so thankful that you are here. On number one, I need help. We are, us as a human being, we think that we need to do everything alone. But we are not created with our body, with our brain. We cannot do things alone. So start using each other's power. Start using each other's skills. Because if you go alone, you can go really fast. But if you go together, you get further. I repeat, if you go alone, you go fast. If you go together, you go further. So reach out to each other and use each other's help. It was my biggest pain to ask someone for help. But now, after 5-6 years, I'm asking everybody for help. And it feels as a power and not as weakness. So that's what I want to tell you. So we are going to talk about young entrepreneurship. I live in the Netherlands, and in the Netherlands we have a bit more than 17 million people living. 1.7 million. In the Netherlands, we have over 2.4 million registered companies. What? Yes, one out of seven people in the Netherlands have a registered company. In the Netherlands, you can register your company by paying 500,000 rupiah, by going to the registration office in the city where you live, and by filling out one piece of paper. And then you have your own company. I know it is different in Indonesia, but we in Western Europe live in a part of the world where entrepreneurship is really motivated. So if you start up a company, who here in the room, who is thinking about starting up an own company in the future? Who's thinking about it? Anyone thinking about starting an own company? Who wants to have their own business? Don't be shy, come on. Yeah. No, you're definitely not the only one. Why would you like to start up your own business?
I think it's because I like to manage my things myself, not doing because of people tell me to do. I think that's why I'm going to make a own company, but I don't know where to start.
Yeah, but this is a great argument. This is exactly what I wanted to hear. A lot of people start their business because they want to have a certain kind of freedom. And he wants to have the freedom that he is not going to work what someone else is telling him to do. And I'm sure that many of you also have the same feeling about that. I started my own company because I want to be free. And my definition of free is free of choice, free of money, and free of location. I want to work when I want, how I want, and where I want. And I am 42 now, and since 5 years, I reached that goal. And that's important for me. So I am sure that many people here in the room also think about starting up the business. And what I want you to do is think about the why. There is a why. And unfortunately, out of that 2.4 million companies in the Netherlands, 75% of these companies, they die within 5 years. Oops. Only 25% survives the first 5 years. Why? Because of the fact that many people in Europe start their company because of status. Because they want to show the rest of the world how great they are. But what I wish for you is that if you start your business, start it because of what is happening here in your heart. Don't start it because you feel that people are expecting things. Don't start because you feel that you become a better person or that you become to have a bit more status. It's not about that. Can you imagine when you are hopefully 80, 85, 90 years old, that you are laying on your bed in the last days of your life? Just imagine the last days of your life, laying in the bed with your loved ones around you. You don't want to say to your loved ones, "Thank you so much. I'm so thankful that I created such a good life for all of you. My wife, my kid, my colleague, my friend." No. I want you to say, "Thank you very much, my loved ones. I created a great life for myself together with you." And that's what we don't realize. You are not born, you are not on this planet to create a good life for someone else. First, start to create your own life. And where does it go wrong? It goes wrong because we are shy and because of the fact that we think that we need to serve another first. And there is a difference between being selfish and being egocentric. We call it egocentric. The difference is that if you are selfish, you're putting yourself on the first place by damaging someone else. But if you are egocentric, you are putting yourself on the first place so that you can serve someone else better. It is for a reason that when you are flying on a plane, that they say that if you need the air, which is on top of your seat, first help yourself and then others. Otherwise, it's going to be a disaster. And that's what I want you to also create in your life. You can be a much better partner, son or daughter for your parents or friends, if you just take care of your own self-love. Focus on yourself as well. And the thing is that 99% of the things that are happening in our brain, they are conscious. And conscious means that when you came on the earth, you were blueprinted. What does blueprinted mean? Blueprint means that you got some things from the parents or from the people that raised you. And don't forget that your mom, your dad, or the people that raise you now, they do everything out of love, out of care, and out of protection. But there is a big but. We need to realize that they are doing this out of their generation. They are maybe 20, 30, 40 years older. And in their generation, when they were young, they had different opportunities and they probably had less skills or less chances to build up their life. And it is an automatic flow that us in our generation, that we want to fulfill the expectation of mom and dad. We want to fulfill the expectation of the people that raised us. But what I would like you to do is say, thank you, mom and dad. Thank you for raising me. Thank you for being here. Thank you for even putting me on the world. But it is my turn in this world, 2022, to find out my own path. And out of love, I will continue my life. But please don't go back in time. Please don't try to fulfill the needs or the expectations of the people that are raising you. You're free to go. Realize that. And then comes the point that if you keep on doing things as you did, you will keep on getting what you got. I will repeat, if you keep on doing what you did, you keep on getting what you got. So if you are staying in your bubble, in your comfortable life, in your day-by-day schedule, how are you going to change? We can wish to change, we can have a dream to change, but the change is not going to land on your lap by the wind, by you just waiting for the change. If you want change, you need to get into action. And this is the hard part as well. Because if we want to go out of our comfort zone, and the comfort zone is that comfortable bubble where we are just doing the things as we did. If you want to go out of your comfort zone, it costs you pain, disappointment, and maybe also a bit nervosity or anger or fear. But if you feel anger or fear, in my opinion, then you know that you are changing yourself. I learn until the last day of my life, I'm learning. I'm learning from the conversations with you. I'm learning from the cultures that I'm experiencing. But if you really want to make a difference, especially in this world, you need to do things also in a different way. And I would like to challenge you because you have received a workbook by WhatsApp. I created the workbook especially for you. And in the workbook, I'm asking you questions like, what is your why? Why would you like to start up your own business? But also, you can think about why you find it important to do things different. And start with small steps. Because if you want to say, okay, Rob, it was great. From today, I'm going to totally change my life. Probably you're going to be disappointed because the steps you want to take are too huge. Every step is a single milestone. So take small steps. Because then sometimes you can give yourself this and say, hey, well done. I'm changing. I'm doing a good job. And then there is the little voice. This is one of the most important things of what I want to share with you. Every single human has a little voice, and it's sitting on your shoulder. It's also sitting on my shoulder. Who is your little voice? Your little voice is your kid when you were a kid, like 6, 7 years old. The little voice is your short, your small version. Like when you were 5, 6, 7, 8 years old. What is happening? And I'm just curious, I want to know if you recognize what I'm going to say. Your little voice has one goal. And the goal of your little voice is to keep everything how it is now. Don't change, don't grow, don't do things different. It's the kid inside you. But there is a version of you that lives today, and I have the same. I am also carrying my 7-year-old version, like Rob, the small version. I'm carrying it around in the world. And I will give a practical example. If I'm in the Netherlands, I'm doubting on the couch after dinner, shall I watch Netflix or do I go to the gym? I don't talk to anybody around me. I'm just discussing with myself. Shall I watch Netflix or do I go to the gym? Shall I ask for help or should I just move on and see if it's going to be fine? The thing is, the going to the sport is the Rob version 2022. But the shall I watch Netflix is the kid who wants to do everything the same and just move on how it is. But this is what you need to realize. If you want to change your life, if you want to provide freedom for yourself, but also for your family, you need to be aware of the fact that you have a small kid that you are carrying. And a lot of people that I'm coaching clients in Europe, America, Asia, they say, ah, Rob, really nice story. I don't have it. It's fine. But in my opinion, and out of my experience, everyone has it. So stop avoiding and doing this defense, but just realize it, go with the flow, and don't punch your short version, because what happens if at the end you are watching Netflix at the couch? You are mad at yourself. And oh, when you go to bed, oh, I didn't sport again, and now I need to do it tomorrow, and I have no time. So don't fight with your little version, but just embrace it, say yes, and say, hey, we're going to do this together for the next 50, 60, 70 years. Always realize this. And I think this is a big eye-opener for you. If you want to change, you need to put your little kid version on the right level. So these are the little voices. The discussions that we are having. The people pleaser, I actually discussed this one already. Be careful with your time, your energy, and your focus about what you're doing in your daily life. Of course, it's kind, it's nice, it's humble to take care about others, but please don't forget yourself, because at the end, you get frustrated and mad to yourself as well. Like, hey, where am I? Then also in the workbook, which you receive by WhatsApp, I also asked you a question, what is your definition of happiness? And the thing is, everything you write down for yourself, it's always true. No one else in the world may influence your definition of happiness. And a lot of people say, Rob, I don't need to write it down. I know it already. There is a huge difference between thinking things and writing things down. Not on your iPad, not on your laptop, but move the pen on the paper. Because if you write down your goals, if you write down your needs, it becomes real. I also have it in my wallet. In my wallet, I have my 5 life goals, and I always carry them with me. And sometimes I open it, and I read it, and I put it back. It's there to keep me sharp and awake and think about, okay, Rob, am I on the right track? What do I need to decide? Does this serve my life and my goals? But start making a goal first. It's really important. We discussed already that if you are willing to make a goal in your life, or if you're willing to make wishes, then you can create the path, how to get there. And that's important because, again, if you have no goal, if you have no dream today, and it's all good, eh? If you don't have a goal, if you don't have a dream, it's fine. But I'm thankful that I have this time with you because I want you to create a goal or a dream. And the world, 2022, needs you all to create a better place for your children, because we are having huge problems in the world. And these problems cannot be solved by your and my mom and dad. We are needed. So we need to step up and don't lay down and stay in our bubble. So another good exercise for you in your own life is to realize which people are around you. And what I would like you to do, it's also in the workbook, is make a list of 5 people that you spend the most time with in your life. And this is going to be interesting. Maybe you have it already in your mind. Who are the 5 people that you spend most time in your life with? You can probably already think about it or write it down. You know what? You are the average of these 5 people. In terms of how they live, how they think, how they act, how they love themselves, you are the average of the 5 people that you spend most time with. Can you change these 5 people? Yes or no? Can you change the 5 people that you're living around with? I see some yes. Yeah, you can. And of course, you cannot change your mom or dad or your family or the people that raised you. But I love to be the most worst kid in the class. Because if I am the most worst kid in the class, I can learn from the other people around me. And that is what I wish for you as well. Try to find out if you have any role models. I have my role models. Richard Branson is a role model. The Dalai Lama is a role model. Barack Obama is a role model. And why do I have my role models? Because of each of these persons, I want to copy-paste something in my life. That's what I aim for. So try to think about role models also for you. And then something about perception. Because it is a fact that we all want to be loved, we all want to be cared, but we need to realize that we can only be loved and cared if we love ourselves. And I'm coaching clients that are doing over $10 million of business a year. And then they are mad at me as a coach and they ask, Rob, why do I feel that I am not loved? Why do I feel that when I am with people, I just don't feel good enough, I don't feel seen, I don't feel empathy? You know what the answer is? The answer is inside that person, inside my client. If you don't love yourself, and if you don't care about yourself, how can you expect someone else to love and care for you? And this is a hard one, but it's good to realize that. So start working on yourself, also in business. Urgent versus important. If we are living our day-by-day life, we are only working on urgent things. Urgent things are having breakfast, paying a bill, going to school, and these kind of things. Urgent things are the things that need to be done today or in a short term. Important things are things that are important for the rest of your life. And what are we doing as a human being? We are as a rat in a wheel, we are having our own rat race in our life. Just every day running, taking care of everything and thinking about all the expectations of others. And at the end of the day, at the end of the week, at the end of the month, at the end of the year, at the end of your life, you are tired of the life that you live. So, why do I share this with you? You need to schedule time to work on your important things. And again, something that is important for you is a long-term issue. And if you schedule it in your agenda, then it's in your focus. And if we are in a high emotional level, if we are highly emotional, positive or negative, our IQ is running on a low level. If you decide things, small or big things, on a high level of emotion, the decision is going to be made on a low level IQ. Think about that. So always try to raise your emotional level down. Like, okay, Rob, slow down. Don't say yes, slow down. Because if you slow down your emotions, your IQ is slowly going up. And we are back in life. We are back in reality. And if you can level your emotions, you can level your IQ as well. And this is also a really important one because many people are making huge decisions out of emotion. And then comes the point. How can you start up your own business? I have been discussing quite a lot of things with you about what you need to do as a person. Because your business is based on your personal growth. And when I'm coaching my clients, many clients like, okay, Rob, I need you. We are going to work on a business plan and I will start in 4 months. It's not going to happen with me. First, I want you to answer, what is your why? What are your dreams and goals in life? And why would you like to start up your own business? These questions need to be answered. Don't just start in high emotion, like, oh, I want to have my own business. No. So how you can start is mentioned here. You need to have clarity for yourself. It's your business, so you need to decide what you would like to do and why you would like to do it. The second one is that we need to speak out our talents, our ambition. Do you realize that if you need to talk to a friend, and if you need to tell me about the capacity, the talents, and where your friend is good at, you can tell many things. But if I'm asking you as a person, hey, where are you good in? What are your talents? What are your skills? We block, we close the curtain because we get shy and we find it so difficult to talk about our own talents. But hey, if you are so good in describing someone else's person's talents, skills, and where another person is good at, don't be shy. Again, put yourself in the middle. You're worth living here, and you may have your goals and dream. So speak it out. Because if you believe in yourself, and if you show that to the world, then you can accept also clients, business, turnover. That's really important. So a lot of companies, this is really funny, a lot of companies in the world are created out of frustration. Can you imagine? Maybe you have the same experience in your life, that when you are in the city, you buy a product or a service, and you think like, oh my God, I could have done this much better. This can be about material, price, service. And we have a lot of these examples. And I'm going to show you an example about people that start their business out of frustration. And these are the big chances that you can grab. The money is literally on the street. You just need to focus on it. Get out of the rat race and focus on important things. It's much easier as you think it is. And then you can also improve other companies by following them or copying them. I'm going to discuss this tomorrow and the day after much more in detail. Today I'm staying a bit on the surface. I'm sharing a lot of information. But tomorrow and Friday, I'm going to go much more in detail. I'm going to show you this video. Please click the button. This is one of my role models called Simon Sinek.
The why was born out of pain. It was never an academic or commercial exercise. It was born out of a time in my life, many years ago, 10 years ago, where I had lost my passion for what I was doing. I owned my own small business. I was living the American dream. Superficially, my life was fantastic. And yet, I didn't want to wake up and do it again. And I was embarrassed by that. You know, who am I to complain about my life? My life seemed perfect, and yet I hated it. And so I kept it to myself. Every ounce of my being, all the energy that I had was invested in pretending that I was happier, more successful, and more in control than I felt. And it was debilitating, quite frankly. Strange things start to happen when you put yourself in that cycle and the stress starts to build. You start to become paranoid. So for example, I was convinced that my employees hated me. I didn't go out much, and it was really a bad time. And it wasn't until a friend of mine came to me, concerned that I wasn't acting myself, and basically offered me nothing more than moral support. Whatever you need, I got your back, I'm worried about you. And it was that simple act that gave me the courage to face my own problem. And it was that simple act that gave me the courage to seek out a solution, to go back to the way I used to feel, to be passionate about something again. There was a confluence of events, and I made this discovery that every single organization on the planet, even our own careers, always function on the same three levels. What we do, how we do it, and why we do it. And it was based on the biology of human decision making. It wasn't some highfalutin management theory. It was based on brain stuff. And I realized I knew what I did and was good at it. And I knew how I did it. I could tell you what was different or special about the way I did things. But I couldn't tell you why I was doing it. That was the missing piece. You have to have all three. I became obsessed with this thing called the why. I figured out how to find my why, and it restored my passion to levels I had never experienced before. And more importantly, I figured out how to help others find theirs. And I did what anyone would do. When you discover something beautiful, you share it with your friends. And my friends started making crazy life changes themselves. And they started finding happiness and passion that they'd never experienced before. It was me solving my own problem that happened to help others solve it for them too. And people just kept inviting me, and I just kept saying yes. I was making huge decisions that were really easy to make. Like, I shut down my office and started over again because I realized the business I had built was so inconsistent with my why. All my friends thought I went out of business and they were worried about me. It was the easiest decision I ever made. In other words, when you know your why, the filter is clear. It's not like there are options. The option is obvious. There's only one option. Share, give, inspire. And everything that I've achieved, any success that I've enjoyed, has all been 100% because of the gracious, just amazing generosity of people around me. My friends, my colleagues, people who just believe what I believe, they are the ones who either introduced me to others or took a risk or said, let me try that, or bought a book or watched a TED Talk, or more importantly, sent it to somebody else because they thought they would be inspired by it. For all of the things that I've done over the past decade, I still feel like I'm at the beginning. I've been saying it for 10 years. When everybody says to me, you know, congratulations on X, Y, or Z, my answer is always the same, tip of the iceberg. And I think that's what keeps me inspired, which is, for me, it's a journey. I'm on the right path. I'm walking past the right mile markers. In other words, I know I'm making progress to the vision that I have to build this world in which the vast majority of people wake up every single morning, inspired to go to work, feel safe when they're there, returning home at the end of the day, fulfilled by the work that they do. When I started the race, I ran by myself. And it's lonely, lonely, lonely. And now I got like a 1,000 people to the left and 1,000 people to the right, and 1,000 people behind me. And I look around, I'm like, yep, we're gonna change the world. We're gonna change the world. There you go.
I love you.
So it's all about your why. It's not about what product, what service, and it's also not about how you are going to sell it. It's about why you want to start up your business. Start with that single first question, please. This is an example of a company that is raised out of frustration. This is really funny, I'm gonna tell you. UPS, 1907 it started, so it's now 115 years old. Nowadays it has $61 billion of US dollar turnover a year, and they do 18.3 million packages a year, and they have 237 planes. What happened? There was a guy in Arizona, America, entering a package shop where he wanted to deliver his package to send to California to his sister. And inside the package, there were medicines, because his sister couldn't get the medicines in California and he could get them in Arizona. So he walks in, he drops his package, and the guy from the package desk is asking him, hey, what's the weight? What is inside? So he needed to fill out the form, like, okay, and what's the price from the product inside? So he filled it in, and then medicines. And then the guy behind the desk says, oh, sorry, sir, we don't do medicines to other states. So the guy was not allowed to send medicines to his sister in California because it was another state of the USA. Now listen very carefully. This guy delivered his package in 1970 to the UPS desk. And you think what happened? 1 year later, he started FedEx. Why? Out of frustration. And now, 2022, you see what FedEx is doing in terms of turnover, packages, and planes. And this is what I mean. This is a practical example of how you can start your own business out of frustration. Another interesting thing I would like to share is about these three companies. This is also an example of why the money is on the street. Let's talk about Airbnb. We all know Airbnb, huh? Okay. Does Airbnb own any property? No. Does Airbnb own any hotel, holiday home? No. What does Airbnb do? They are just making profit out of connecting owners of holiday homes to people who would like to rent holiday homes. So the market was already there. People were already asking for holiday homes. And the people that offer holiday homes were also already there. Airbnb was thinking, hey, we should create a platform and connect the people that are asking to the people that are offering. Airbnb is one of the top 10 companies in the world at the moment. So think about opportunities. Can you connect several services or products and make it your own new product? Second example, Pinterest. They are just connecting people and people hobbies, interests, into a platform where they make huge turnovers now. And it's the same with Spotify as well. The sheet is gone, but Spotify, do they own artists, singers, bands? No. Are they contracting these musicians? No. They just created a platform where you can go on for free, and then you need to pay on the moment that you really like it. And I want you to realize something. Who is on Instagram here? Hands up. Who is on Instagram? Instagram? Yeah, like 50%. Okay. Do you know, I'm also on Instagram and I have a free account. I don't pay anything. And I think you also have a free account. You know what the funny thing is? When you are using something for free, you think that you are the client. Thank you. No, you are the product of Instagram. But think about it. Instagram wants you to be as long as possible on their platform because they are making money from the advertisers. Isn't it brilliant? Why can you watch a YouTube video 30 seconds for free and after that you get an ad? Because they want you to pay to not get the ad. So be clever, be fresh, and be aware of everything where you register. Because if you can register for free, you became a product. It's so interesting. Okay, we are going to discuss this subject. I think I still have 5 minutes, about? Yeah, 5 minutes, okay, and then we start the Q&A. There are some subjects that tomorrow and the day after we are going to highlight. And these subjects are about the business plan, it's about getting finance, because a lot of people think like, oh, I have a great idea, I have time, but it's not going to work. That is, again, the little voice on your shoulder. Start to act and think different. Because have you been trying to think out of the box? There are many ways of financing your new business idea. And in the practical workbook that I have been publishing, which is also in Bahasa Indonesian available, I will launch it next week on Bali. In the practical workbook, I'm also explaining the ways of getting finance. I'm just going to explain you some ways of getting finance. Bank, private investor, crowdfunding, friends and family, but also the last one, the most important, a lot of startups are selling their product or service before they even created it. Again, a lot of startups are selling their product or service and getting in the money from the client before they even produced it. And this is the smart and the clever part. Because let's say if you have a great idea for a product that you would like to sell, why wouldn't you make promotion on social media, create a website, and start selling your first 100, 500, or 1,000 pieces, and tell your clients that they are in the opportunity, that they are your first clients, limited edition, only now, 1 million rupiah. Buy it now and you will get it in 2 months at your doorstep for free, no delivery costs. A lot of startups are starting like that. They're testing the market, getting in the money, and then going to the fabric and asking, hey, can you make me 500 of these? These kind of out-of-the-box things are really modern ways of financing your own company. So these questions, marketing, sales, strategy, these questions are also going to be discussed tomorrow and Friday. when I'm doing other seminars as well. I would like to wrap up with this one, and this is all about us. In English, we are called human. How do we call human? Being. We are not called human doing. So what I would like you to realize is that sometimes you just slow down, stop, stand still, and think, what am I doing? Am I doing right? Am I having the right goals? Am I spending my time and energy in the right way? And what is happening, and that's the reason why I created the triangle. In the triangle, we are all having this triangle. I also have the triangle. But as human being, what we are doing, we are mainly living in this part of the triangle. We are just living our rat race, doing. But we forget our foundation, the most important part of the triangle, which is the being part. Because we have so much urgent things to do. So I want you to realize that there is a reason why we are called human being. And a lot of people are doing a lot because they avoid to be. Because if they try to be, they get mad, stressed, nervous, and angry. Because things are getting in our mind and in our body. They're just avoiding to have this feeling. But don't take the feeling with you for the rest of your life. You have the benefit that you're young now. So try to get rid of this. And it took me years. It took me years. But I am free now, free to go. And I love myself. So, final sheet, and then we go to the Q&A. If you want to start up your own business, it's good to follow these highlights as well. These are important things. Are you willing to first serve? And what I mean with first serve, we are here at the Design University. Are you willing to work for free for your first client? For a day, a week, maybe a month. Because the thing is, if you are willing to work for free, you give your potential client the possibility to get to know you, your personality, your skills. And a lot of people, they have a huge ego, we call it. We call it pride. And they say, oh, I'm not going to work for free. That's not what I learned from my mom and dad. But I'd like you to see things a bit different. Why wouldn't you go in for a certain period, for a certain project, show your skills, show your willingness? You have a way much bigger chance that people are going to hire you. This is the first serve strategy. It works in the United States very well. And it worked for me too. Another thing is about sales and marketing funnels. I'm going to discuss that tomorrow and the day after. This is all about how you can sell your product or service to the client. And the last and final thing is about celebrating your goals. You can celebrate every step that you make. If you made a small step, we forget to celebrate because we are tough for ourselves. So this is the last thing that I wanted to discuss. I'm just going to this is an important one. So I want to finalize this seminar and then I'm open for all your questions. I want to add value to your lives and I want you to realize that when you walk down the stairs and if you walk out, I just hope that you have one, two or three things that you took from me this morning in doing things different. It's needed. We live in a world of discrimination, terrorism, war, and unacceptance. And it is needed that we step up. There's nothing to fear. There's nothing to worry about. Just go for it. Thank you very much for attending, and I'm open for your questions. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. It's very mind-opening, right, guys? Oh, thank you, Rob, for sharing all the things that very important for us to, you know, get out from the bubble zone. Thank you. And right now, we are opening for any question from the students, perhaps, or the guests. You can ask in Bahasa also, don't worry, yeah? So the very important thing is we do have a special moment with Rob right now, so it's your chance to ask anything, guys. I mean, like, anything. Come on, perhaps, is there any three of you want to ask something about around that you think? Oh, okay, we got the first one.
Oh, shall I? Oh, okay. Check. Okay. Good morning. Thank you very much for the presentation. That was brilliant. I like it. I'm Nagata. And as you can say, my question is, I still don't know how to make the first step of doing a business. Like many people in Indonesia just doing their business without any foundation, without any concept at the first time, but it ended really bad. Yeah. They stopped and they don't grow as much as they expected, right?
Yeah.
So what I want to ask is, what is the first things that you have to know before you start a business?
Thank you very much for the questions.
Is it the products that you have to really think about it, or it's the business concept that you have to do first?
Yeah. Thanks a lot for the question. Is there any field of business where you would like to start in?
I would like to have a... Actually, I would like to have a fashion business.
Yeah.
But still, I still have no idea what the products that I want to sell. But I'm kind of interested with the fashion and the trending.
Yeah. So something like your own brand, for example... Like your own fashion brand?
Yep, my fashion brand, yeah.
Yeah. The most important thing, and I know that in Indonesia many people are starting and just experiencing if it's going to work or not. It's actually a bit the same like in the Netherlands. But what is really important is that you do your market research. And what I learned at school, and probably you learned it as well, is that you need to do a competition analysis. We call it a competition analysis. So if you have a good idea, the school is asking, okay, have a look if any other company is doing it already. That's important. But I don't call it a competition analysis. I call it a branch partner analyze. Why? Because a branch partner analyze is much more positive. If you have a good idea now, check out which companies are doing that and don't be afraid of them, like, it's already done, someone else is making money, I can quit. No. You need to realize that if someone else is doing it for a couple of years, they probably have a lot of success and you can do it different or better. So there are two things that you need to do. You need to do market research. So ask people around you if they are interested in your product and if they have any feedback about your type of product. That's the first thing. And be careful, don't only ask people in your family or in your friend zone. Ask people outside. For example, with an online inquiry form or something. But if you're asking feedback to people that you don't know, you get honest feedback. Yeah, so market research is one, and two is the branch partner analyze. And I do advise you, because you're keen to learn, I know that, I see it, but I do advise you that if you have the dream to start your own fashion brand, you have the energy, you have good brains, just start taking your first steps and practice, practice, practice. Because if you decide for yourself, okay, I'm going to be on this wave of entrepreneurship. I'm going to prepare. I'm going to make steps. Then along the journey, you will find different challenges and things that you need to do. And your first steps are finding out, and this is actually my final answer to your question. So we talked about market research, branch partner analysis, but the most important is, who do you want to be your client? That's the most important thing, and that's the reason why I wanted to share this video. I learned at school that if you want to start a business, you need to focus on your product or service. That's step one. And by the way, what I'm explaining now is old school, and this is not how I advise you to do it. But I learned it like, okay, you have a product or a service, or you're thinking about it. That's step one. Step two, how am I going to do the sales and the marketing and how I'm going to sell it? Step three, who am I going to sell it to? And I call it old school. This is how the reality was. But now comes the funny thing. 2022, nowadays we do this 1, 2, 3 step. We do it in a different order. We do 3, 2, 1. And that's the reason why I answer your question. First step, who do you want to work for? Who is going to be your client? Which branch, which theme, which subject, generation, girl, boy, age, income, social background. If you know who your client is going to be, like, it would be great if I can work. Let's say you want to become a graphic designer. Don't make the first step and think like, I'm good in this, I can do UX design, I'm good in WordPress, etc. Okay, and then how am I going to sell it? And oh yeah, by the way, who am I going to sell it? No, this is old school. Do it the other way around. You know your skills, you know where you're good at. So think about who you want to work for. If you want to be a graphic designer for yourself, think about which branch, which brands, what kind of companies you would like to work for. If you have that clear, then you take step two, like, okay, how does this kind of clients or companies would like to be approached? How do they like to be communicated with? Which platforms are they on? And then after that, you say, okay, I know who my ideal client is. I know how to reach it. Step one, how am I going to upgrade and improve my service so I can answer my future client question in the best way? And this is thinking upside down. Does this make sense for you?
Yep, that was makes sense for me. It's crystal clear. Thank you very much.
Any other question?
Okay. Ada lagi yang mau bertanya? Mumpung ada Mr. Rob tadi juga mind-blowing juga ya, about change your point of view of making a business ya, from the old school style. Perhaps ada yang mau tanya dalam bahasa juga nggak apa-apa. Yuk, mumpung ada Pak Robnya di sini. Silakan, jangan malu-malu. Ayo. Atau mungkin ada yang mau sharing, mau bisnis apa gitu. Siapa tahu kan dapat insight. Ada? Monggo. Oh,
check. Hello, Mr. Rob. Okay. So, Mr. Rob, is a really common question from me. Entrepreneurs is kind of taboo in Indonesia, especially in Indonesia. We mostly told by the society to be an employee is really more safe than becoming entrepreneurs, because that unsupportive ecosystem that mostly we are going like, oh no, I'm so scared to build a business because I have no support from the family. I will be bankrupt. And so many things will happen, and we're not ready for that. So the question is, how do we take the very first step to encourage ourselves to do the business?
Yeah, thanks a lot for the question.
Yeah, thank you.
What he's saying is that you need to take a lot of risk. You don't know if it's going to be succeeded. It takes a lot of energy and time when you start a business. It's true. But these are the things that are said by mainly the people that are older, by the generation past, because that's their blueprint. That is how they were living. Just do normal and do this is the child version of yourself. And what he's also asking, like, hey, how can we really change this? And the only way you can change, and that's a good practical advice from my side, I am an entrepreneur since 17 years, 17. I started my first company when I was 25. I started my company by working part-time, 3-4 days a week, as a sales manager for a hotel. So I earned my income in the Netherlands, but my side dish, working in the evening on my business, working in the weekends, my side dish was creating my business. So I combined the security, the safe part of earning income by being creative and also building up my own business. And sometimes if you want to work on your passion project, I call it a passion project, if you want to work on that, for example, your own business, sometimes you need to do certain things to make that happen. And these certain things can be working on a contract base. I worked the first 3 years of my company, I worked on a contract base 3 days a week. And after 3 years in my business, I earned more than I did in the 3 days contract. So that made me change, like, okay, now I'm done, full-time business. Is that an answer to your question? Yeah. Thanks.
Okay. Wow, thank you for sharing that. Okay, again, please, if you do have another question, please, guys. You can also ask in Bahasa. Don't be shy. This is a perfect moment for you to ask, because you are, yeah, we are having Mr. Rob here now. Perhaps, or do you want to share something that you thinking about that you want to make by your own, perhaps? Is there any help? Okay, okay, we got one.
Good afternoon. My name is Jay, and I would like to ask about is it okay to start a business slowly to make sure that we achieve the mission of the business itself? And how do you think that pace of starting a business is important?
Thank you very much for your question. Do you have any idea about which field you would like to start a business?
I am actually starting a business with my friend because of a college assignment, actually. And we already have the mission, but we also have certain deadlines.
Yeah.
However, I think to start, because we want to start this business seriously, we want this to be as good as it can be. So we're starting it slowly. That's why I'm asking if a pace of starting a business is important.
Yeah. And what specifically are you doing in your business? Are you selling a product or a service?
We are selling product.
What product?
The product is it's a journal. It's a guidebook, actually.
Yeah.
To increase more interest in writing, and the main goal is actually to pouring out how we feel about certain things. Because I know that it's hard to talk to other people. There are people who are not having an easy time to communicate how they're feeling, and that's the main goal, is to just help people understand themselves better by that.
Wow! If I understand you right, it's in Europe we would call it a journaling book.
Yes.
Yeah. Wow. Fully respect. And when did you start your business?
We're actually in development. Still, we're still designing.
Yeah, but you want to start. That's for sure.
Yes. Because we have to start it. Yeah. But we're still taking a time to designing everything. So yeah. it's good enough.
Wow! Thank you very much for standing up. Please give her an applause. So I fully respect Jane's plan to start up her own business, and there are a couple of things I would like to respond. The first thing is, if you start your business, it's better to start good than to start fast. And that's exactly what you also share with me, like, hey, things still need to be finalized, etc. But then, you're still young, you're going to college, you have other responsibilities, so you don't want to start with a big bang. Let's call it that way. So what you can do, especially by selling these journaling books, which is, by the way, a really popular trend in my area of the world, Western Europe, and I totally understand the purpose of the book as well. What I would do is, before you even create a website with a web shop, start working on your social media first. And it's really important, because nowadays we are talking about people to people in business, and not about business to business, business to consumer. It's about people to people. So if I was in your position, I would start doing promotion on social media by just taking the viewers by the hand and sharing the experience that you're having in opening your business. Because if you create a podium online before you start selling and opening a website, then you already have, within a half a year or 9 months or whenever you want to start, you already have 500, 1,000, 2,000 people that somehow wanted to connect with you because they feel a connection. So my first advice is, start with social media. Make the people a bit crazy. Make them feel hungry, like, hey, what are they doing? So don't show yourself totally, but just give them every time a piece of the puzzle with every post you make. Talk about the theme, write about yourself as well, and write about your why. I showed you Simon Sinek, the small video. If you go to YouTube, you can find so many videos of him, but he's one of my role models. So social media is one. Give them pieces of the puzzle, so don't show the final product. And then, even if you say, like, okay, I decide to launch the website January 1st, 2023. What I advise you to do, it's now June, so you can start social media. 1st of October, 3 months before, start to promote. And I also said it in financing way, start to sell before you produce. So the second step, for example, 3 months before launch of the website, you're gonna give an offer that they cannot refuse, make it a great offer, and let them tell them that it's a limited edition, that the shipping costs are for free for the next month, or that you say the first 100 copies are for a discounted rate. But if you do that, it's totally funny, before you even started the company and launched your website at January 1st, you're already making money this year. That's how life should be, isn't it? Yeah, that's it. So I hope these ideas will help. And I think this is the most important. But also think in worldwide perspective. Don't only think about Bali. Because we are living in a world that, thanks to the digital world, we can serve any client in the world. So if you aim for the moon, you will go to the stars. So make it big in your mind. Yeah? Happy with the answer? Okay, thanks.
Okay, wow, see. We still have one time. We still have time for one question. This is our last chance for you to ask directly to Mr. Rob. Do you have any question, guys?
And otherwise, I would like to show one sheet more. if possible.
Oh, okay, okay.
If we can go back to the presentation.
I think we can go there, yeah.
Because as I said, I will launch my practical workbook in Bahasa next week here on Bali. It's physically not here because it's still at the printing agency. I just want to share with you my social media account, but also my WhatsApp mobile number, because I will be in Bali until first week of August. So I still have time here. I go to Singaraja, I go to Sanur, I go to Uluwatu. I have a tour where I'm visiting many universities. What I would like you to share is that if you, here we go. So if you are interested in having the book in Bahasa, or if you're interested in contacting me about any question, just send me a WhatsApp message and I would be happy to serve you. And if you would like to have the book, I give you a participant seminar prize, which is lower than the general prize. And I will make sure that it is delivered on your name here at the university. And then you are one of the first who is going to have the book, and even signed by me. So this is the opportunity I give you, also as a thank you for being here. My details are going to be shown. Here are my details. You see my phone number? It's my private mobile number, the number above, which is starting with +31. So write it down or make a picture. If you're interested in contacting me, you can also contact me on Instagram. If you want to have the book, I can make sure that it's here at the university within the next weeks. Thank you very much.
Okay, Rob, do you have any one last question? I mean, like, we do have one last question from the online audience. Can you okay
please,
with it?
Please.
So the question is, before I ask you a question that I want to introduce myself. My name is Dian from Digital Business Major. In your talking about business presentation, you said that we must have role modeling and peer group. Why you choose role modeling and peer group? Are they really impact for business? The question from Dewa Ayu.
Thank you very much for your question from the online participant. Out of my experience, I need people around me that are inspiring me and motivating me, because I want to learn. If I would be here 5 years ago, I would give my life a 10 out of 10, and I would say you all that I have nothing to learn from you. My life changed in the last 5 years so much because of the fact that I opened myself for inspiring people around me. Can you imagine that if you are living with five people in your peer group that are laying down, relaxing, living a day-by-day life, I think it's easy to understand that you are going to copy-paste their way of behave, their way of living, etc. I'm not talking about good and wrong, but you can change this. If you are in an environment of fire, power, energy, and positivity, you're also going to have it yourself. And that's the reason why I find it important to surround yourself with people that give you energy and motivation and inspiration. So if, let's say, 3, 4, 5 people in this room would like to start their own business together with Jane here and with this big boss here on row number one, go together, make a peer group together, and just catch up with each other. Because if you have the same energy and the same wishes, why shouldn't they learn from each other? That's the way you can make things happen. Reach out to each other. Thanks for the question.
Thank you for the answer, Rob. Thank you. So we do have a finish of the time. And let's, again, we give a warm applause to Mr. Rob. Thank you very much, Mr. Rob.
So, okay, thank you very much, Mr. Rob, for a really great presentation and also for the sharing. It's a really good answer too. Yeah. Okay, so, ladies and gentlemen, guys, for our next session, agenda is photo session with Mr. Rob. But first thing first, we would like to invite our moderator and also Pak Putu to join us in here to do the photo session. Pak Putu? Sebelah sini. Di sini aja boleh. Di atas, di bawah aja sih Pak. Okay, thank you, Pak Putu and Pak James. And then we continue to do the photo session with the audience. Where do we should do the photo session? I'm sorry. Okay, so we invite all of the audience to come forward to take a photo with Pak. Okay, so guys, I invite all of you to come forward to do the photo session with Mr. Rob.
Yuk kita foto dulu. Nanti kalian bisa di atas ini juga, ya. Yeah. Jadi bisa di samping kita sama di atas ya. Kita di bawah sure. Untuk melindungi ini takut keinjak.
Yeah. Oke, okay,
mari. Silakan naik ya.
Oke, okay,
naik ya.
Okay.
Maskernya dicopot aja ya.
Check.
So for untuk all of the online audience, please kindly
untuk peserta
on
yang
video.
Online. Yang online bisa dihidupkan bisa kameranya, kita foto bareng.
Halo. Saya yakin sudah mandi semua kayaknya.
Belum. Sabar ya, sabar ya. Silakan.
Ya, di atas boleh. Ya, silakan. Ya. Kepada para panitia, Pak Rama, Pak Freddy, Pak Irfan, Bu Aston, ayo ikut join. Ya. Oke. Kamu cilik ya. Oke, ya. Lumayan banyak ternyata. So many people. Ada yang di depan sini boleh berlutut sporty jadi sporty ya. Yeah. Ya, yeah. Boleh nih tengah sini. Sampai situ ya. Ya, oke okay, ya. Kamu sini ya. Ada lagi yang ini bisa diisi? Yuk. Ya. Yeah. Oke, okay. Itu ada yang nyalon ya, pakai palu lagi. Ya, yeah. Oke, kita lepas masker ya. Gak usah pakai masker ya guys, no masker ya, jangan pakai masker ya. Ya, yeah. Oke okay, ya. Yeah.
kelihatan soalnya guys. Ya, di depan ya. Ya, oke, boleh, boleh.
Check, check. Okay, so the room is already messed before you guys are leaving. We would like to remind you that we will have our second intersession of the seminar in 16th and 17th of June 2022. And don't forget to fill up our questionnaire through our shared link. That's Hello. All our seminar today. Thank you very much for coming. A really big appreciation for your kindness and attention. Thank you. Good afternoon.
Adek-adek, untuk tadi yang nanya, adek-adek, untuk yang tadi nanya, tolong ke Bu Aston ya. Yang tadi merasa menanyakan.